Hey, dude. Listen, okay? Just come clean.
I did.
I don't know why you guys are so afraid about the specifics about your shitty one-year relationship that didn't fucking matter. Well, apparently it mattered enough to hit each other, but it's just 1 year. I've seen fucking people in high school date longer than that. High school relationships, on average, last longer than that shit. I guess I'm just gonna get in my bed, never to find out. I don't know. Who hit who first?
I don't know. As soon as I leave, he'll probably start
running his mouth. I told you everything. Why are you trying to copy me, dude? Get your own personality. Seriously.
I do have my own personality, but I know if I leave before you, you're going to run your fucking mouth.
No, that's never happened. And yeah, find one person. Find me one person that'll say that I talked shit about you, ever. You can't. I can show you a fucking dozen. So you're literally just projecting your same old shit. Like, I hope you all can fucking see how obvious it is. This person is a lying-ass, crazy fucking person. They'll manipulate the fuck out of you. Whether they're pretending to be your friend or what. That's the fucking truth. Learn it the hard way. Learn it the easy way. I don't care. I had good people telling me not to fucking trust this person from the get-go, and I was like, oh, fuck you. And then I learned the hardest way you could learn.
You learned the hardest way?
Yeah, you suffered way more than I did. Nothing relevant to say. I'm sorry. I'll challenge you on everything you fucking say, because everything's a fucking lie, and it's super easy to fucking disprove.
Wait, so who moved... You moved into her house, and then she just whooped your ass?
Yeah, like, let's make a big joke out of domestic violence, but yes, little by little, started with a push, with throwing shit, throwing a fucking shampoo bottle at my head, and I'm like, yo, whatever, but it's a little girl, like, I'm not injured, so whatever, am I gonna be a little bitch about it? No, just carry on with the relationship and say, hey, stop doing that. Hopefully that something clicks, but next time it's a fucking peanut butter jar whizzing by my head, smashing the fucking TV. You know, like, this is the kind of shit that it was. It starts with that, and then it goes to shoving, and then it goes to fucking actual hitting. And when the hitting came, then I used my hands to stop her. So if putting my hands on her to stop her from hitting me is hitting her, I don't know what the fuck else I was supposed to do.
So Darian, the times you tossed me across the room, the times you grabbed me by my hair, the time you put your hands on my throat to scare me, the time you bit my face and broke blood vessels, the time you threw hot eggs on me. Any of those times familiar?
They were not hot eggs. I had just
Pan. They left red marks. I have pictures of that.
That's cool. I've got fucking pictures too.
Cool. Are you gonna make that documentary on it?
I gotta make a documentary on you. You're not worth the time.
Been fucking worth the time this last fucking 2 hours you've been here.
Anyways, Montezuma, that's how it starts, I guess. I don't know. It was the first time I'd been through something like that.
Whenever you isolated me from my fucking family. Whenever you controlled who I could be friends with.
Never isolated you from your family. You never controlled who you could be friends with. You and my mom. No.
You made me choose
between. No, but I did come across a Facebook post. It had been like 2 weeks I had been there. And it was your mom calling me like some kind of homeless shitbag on my Facebook wall. And I was like, how the fuck did I not see it in the beginning? Like, it was quite obvious.
What, you're dating my mom?
No, but she was a big piece of shit to me and you were perfectly fine with it. In fact, you endorsed it, but it's whatever.
My mom could smell you from a mile away, homie. You came here with a fucking car full of shit, hadn't owned your own fucking car, 35 years old, just got your own first fucking car. Like, you didn't own a car.
Interesting, yeah. That's a downside, though, that I used my brain and got homes close to my jobs where I could walk. I don't know. When I needed cars to travel, I rented cars. It was financially smarter than buying a car that I didn't need since I worked from home, you know? But I have a car now. It's nice.
Yeah, good for you.
I mean, if that's your big attack on me.
No, I'm not going to attack you.
No, I said if that was your big attack on me, that I just got a car now.
Yeah. I'm not attacking you. I haven't attacked you. But I'm so not going to have you sitting here saying that you were some fucking domestic violence victim, whatever. It was clearly...
I was. I don't care, though. I'm not trying to, like, get sympathy for it or anything. It was fucked up, and I hope I learned from it. But
I hope you did, too. I hope you learned never to put your hands on another woman ever again.
I hope that I learned that maybe the first time you forgive it, but the second time you just got to go.
The first time I fucking forgave it.
Okay, dude. It's really that the reason I don't even want to talk about it is because you are convincing. It. You're so convincing that like no, I I'm think not. That somewhere in your brain you actually recollect things in this manner. No. And so there is no point in arguing with you because either one, you're just telling a lie that you will never break. It's like some kind of blood oath. Or two, you actually believe what you're saying. Okay, cue the fucking maniacal laughter. Scripted personality. Yeah, it is a scripted personality.
Jesus Christ.
I mean, that was a forced laugh, right? I mean, that wasn't a real laugh. It's like... Don't I have work tomorrow? No, don't you? I don't work a 9-to-5. I have work if I say I want to work.
So, why did you hit him, Babushka?
Well, when you're being pinned down, it's kind of hard to, you know, get a guy that's twice your size off of you. So, of course, you have to hit back.
Well, he said that it started with you just throwing shit at him. So, why did you throw stuff at him?
No. No, that's, you know, I get it. No. I see what you're doing, but no.
You did. That's how it started.
Mm-mm.
The first time it was a TV.
No, it wasn't.
It was the small TV on your nightstand through the wall. That was about 2.5 weeks into the relationship.
Is that when you impersonated Lolly Pants?
Probably some point around that time, yeah. Yeah, so I was dating her and I was living in the house with her. And I knew she was talking to Lolly Pants, so I said, block him, because he's a piece of shit, and I didn't want my girlfriend talking to that guy. But she said she blocked him, and I made an account called Lolly Pants, and I was
it was Dude Guy. Okay, I have the screenshots.
Sure. I'm glad that you remember this, because it just shows who you are, and like...
No, it shows that you're willing to fucking lie to me. I basically
flirted with her, and she flirted back while I was sitting on the couch next to her. No. So. And I stayed through that, so I know I'm fucking stupid. I like telling the story because I like to look stupid.
I was at work when he was texting me. We were on the couch together.
Yeah, we were on the couch together.
No, I was at work.
You were, either way, what does it matter? You were fucking texting and flirting back with him.
Because I knew it was fucking you.
No, you didn't.
Why would he contact me?
That's just delusional, but either way, that's something that happened. And then I found out a lot of other shit that I think most smart people would have been like, fuck this.